Alright, so ibang-iba po ang ating talakayan ngayong gabi kasi wala tayong moderator. Pero so nagkasundo naman kami ni Brother Alvin na pagbutihan po namin ang talakayan natin ngayong gabi. Ang ating topic po ngayon, mga kaibigan, infant baptism po. So we're going to debate with this topic in English and Tagalog or Filipino so that our brethren, yung mga kaibigan natin sa Luzon, maiintindihan nila tayo. Anyway, sa ating mga taga Visayas at Mindanao, wala pong problema, Bro Alvin, ano?
Yes. Oh.
So they can also understand us sa ating dialect or sa Tagalog. So ngayong gabi po, mga kaibigan, hindi na po tayo mag wala na pong or mag-start na po tayo, no? Without further ado, we will start and we will start our program sa pamamagitan po ng panalangin na i-lead po tayo ni Brother Alvin ngayong gabi.
Okay, let us pray. Let us bow our heads together and put our minds and ourselves in the presence of the Lord. Let us pray in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, Heavenly King, praise you, Lord, and glorify you for giving us this time of our life to share your word, O God, in your scriptures, in your holy word. Give us the guidance and light of the Holy Spirit so that we can understand your word and share it to others and live it with our own lives. We ask this in Jesus' name, and thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, together with the glory of the Father in heaven and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
The name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Before starting birthday, we would like to inform our listeners na kami ni birthday is gentleman's agreement lang muna kasi wala ngang moderator. Tapos, 10 minutes lang ang stand, dalawang stand pa rin sa negative o affirmative, and then 5 minutes lang ang cross para may cross din after the second stand, pero 5 minutes pa rin. So, 5-5. And then, summary is 5 minutes each for affirmative and negative. And then if a question is answerable by yes or no, should be answered either yes or no and then qualification within 1 minute. So, ganyan lang, no?
Okay.
So, Bradley, let's start.
So, yan po. Napakadali po naman yung ating rules ng ating debate ngayong gabi. At sasagot ba tayo ng mga tanong, Bro Alvin? No, tatanggap pa tayo ng mga tanong?
Hindi na, kasi magagabihan na tayo. Siguro, pagka-break every time we stand, we can read some of the comments.
Okay, so andito po. Babasahin po namin yung mga tanong nyo o kaya mga comments nyo. So,
pwede rin, after the debate, kung may mga tanong dyan,
meron so mga,
still more time, pwede natin sagutin.
Okay. Alright, so 10 minutes each po tayo ngayon at presentation po tayo 10 minutes sa affirmative side. Sisimulan po ito ni Brother Alvin sa infant baptism ng Roman Catholic Church. Robin?
Thank you, Brother Ray. Good evening once again, everyone. Good evening, Brother Ray. And then, praise God that we have here once again that we are met again tonight, every Friday na yata to, Brother Ray. Parang lahat ng Friday, tatong Friday na tayo nagkatagpo.
Yes.
Now, our topic that we will be with Brother Ray, actually, we have been many topics, pero isisahin lang natin, is infant baptism. So, me as a Catholic, I would prove that infant baptism is a biblical doctrine according to the scriptures. Now, in the Old Testament, St. Paul says that what happened to the Israelites in the Old Testament is a figure of a baptism which is to be done and fulfilled in the New Testament. For example, in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 1 to 4, it reads, the Way Bible, Holy Bible, the Wireless Version, for I would not have you ignorant brethren that our fathers were all under the cloud and all passed through the sea, and all in Moses were baptized in the cloud and in the sea, and did all eat the same spiritual food, and all drank the same spiritual drink, and they drank of the spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 1 to 4. St. Paul was referring to the exodus of the Israelites from the bondage of Egypt into the land of freedom in Israel. And then he was talking about that when they passed through the Red Sea under the clouds, they were rained upon as a figure of baptism, which is also to happen to the Christian church in 1 Corinthians 10, 1-4. So our infants or little children included in that baptism in the time of Moses, which is a figure of the baptism to come. Yes, of course. In Exodus chapter 12, verse 37, and the children of Israel set forth from Ramesses to Sukkoth, being about 600,000 men on foot and children. So children were also there. Exodus 12, 37, 1 Corinthians 10, 1-4. And in the prophets, Joel, one of the minor prophets in the Old Testament, I'm still reading the Old Testament, Douay-Rheims Bible, Holy Bible, Douay-Rheims Version, in the prophet Joel, we can also read that in chapter 2, verse 13, and comma 28-29, there was a prophecy that God would pour His Spirit upon His servants or His church. Joel 2:28-29, and this is quoted by St. Peter in Acts chapter 2, verse 17-22. Let us read the prophecy of Joel. And it shall come to pass after this, that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. So mark the word, the verb pour, meaning pouring of the Spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall receive visions. Moreover, upon my servants and handmaids in those days I will pour forth my Spirit, and will shew the wonders in heaven and in earth, blood and fire and vapor and smoke. And the sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood, before the great and dreadful day of the Lord hath come. And it shall come to pass that everyone that shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be salvation, as the Lord said, and in the residue whom the Lord shall call. Joel 2:28-32. Now this is quoted, as I have noted earlier, by St. Peter himself, one of the chief apostles, in Acts chapter 2, verse 17-20. And this is on Pentecost Sunday, when the Holy Spirit was given as promised by our Lord Jesus Christ in Luke chapter 24, verse 47-53. The fulfillment is Acts chapter 2, verse 1-47. Specifically in verse 38-39, the pouring means the pouring of the Spirit is through the sacrament of baptism, as we can read in Acts chapter 2, verse 38-39. But Peter said to them, do not do penance and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ. So baptism, the subjects is everyone, meaning everybody, all persons, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sins, meaning forgiveness of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. So this is a fulfillment in Acts 2:17-20, when Christ or God will pour the Holy Spirit on all flesh. This is true baptism. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost or Holy Spirit, Acts 2:38-39. For the promise is to you and to your children and to all that are far off, whomsoever the Lord our God shall call. Children in the Greek here means technois, meaning small children, including infants. Now, are infants really included in the prophecy of Joel, letra po letra in the Bible, literally? Yes, of course, in the context of Joel chapter 2, whole of chapter 2, we quoted already and read verse 28-32. Above in 2 verse 13, it reads, and rend your hearts and not your garments, and turn to the Lord your God. For he's gracious and merciful and patient and is willing to have mercy, to give mercy on those who repent of the evil. In verse 16, it says, gather together the people, sanctify the church, assemble the ancients, gather together the infants and the little ones, and then that suck at the breast. So kasama yung mga infants, those who suck at the breast, mga babies, infants, they are to sanctify the church, to assemble the ancients, gathering the people. Joel 2:16, 28-32. And thus the children here includes infants in Acts chapter 2, verse 39, in fulfillment of the prophecy of Joel, Joel 2:17-20, and then Joel 2:22-28-32. Now in France, the Catholic French, because France is a Catholic nation, there is a problem there about infant baptism, because in Acts chapter 2 verse 39, the word infant is really found. So meaning the word children is limited here on the French Bible on infants. Carla promesse est pour vos enfants et pour tous ceux qui sont alone en aussi grand nombre que le Seigneur notre Dieu les appeler. Meaning the promise of baptism to be given the Holy Spirit, Acts 2:30-8, is children in the French Bible, infants. And this is the same word used by St. Peter, Acts 2:38-39, in his first Catholic epistle of St. Peter the Apostle, where in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2, in the French Bible, the seres comes des infants, novo nesne, le light spiritual et pur, afen que parlo, vos crescos por la salud. So, 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2. When we read the Protestant Bible Good News to the New Testament with Psalms and Proverbs in today's English version, the first Catholic epistle of St. Peter the Apostle in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2, it reads, infants ba talaga? Oh.
3 minutes.
Last three minutes. Thank you, Brother Ray. Be like newborn babies or infants, always thirsty for the pure spiritual milk, so that by drinking it, you may grow up and be saved. So infants and spiritual, infants and babies are also given spiritual milk. That is the Holy Spirit in Acts 2:38-39. Kaya nga, letra po letra, infantes, infants, that is included in the sacrament of baptism, Acts 2:38-39, and fulfillment of Joel chapter 2, according to Peter, and 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2. Because in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 20, baptism is needed for salvation. And not only adults, but also infants and babies need salvation, especially from original sin or the sinful nature we inherited from Adam and Eve. 1 Peter 3:20-21, St. Peter categorically and directly says and states, these were the spirits of those who had not obeyed God when they waited patiently in the days that no one was building his boat. The few people in the boat, 8 and all, were saved by the water. It's literal, saved by the water. What water? Verse 21, which was a symbol pointing to baptism, which now saves you, meaning baptism saves you. It is not the washing off of bodily dirt, but the promise made to God from the good conscience. It saves you through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. 1 Peter 3, verse 20-21. So subjects of baptism are everybody, as commanded by the Lord. In Mark chapter 16, verse 15-16, since St. Mark the Evangelist is also a disciple of St. Peter the Apostle, and he was commissioned by St. Peter to write a short gospel about Christ. And Mark 16:15-16 categorically and directly quotes the words of Jesus when Christ commanded the apostles, go therefore throughout the whole world, so everybody, and preach the gospel to all people. All people means including infants and little children. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. So baptism saves. Mark 16:15-16. The difference with me and Bradway is that the Baptist Church does not believe that baptism saves. But in the Bible, two verses that I have read earlier, Mark 16:16, letter by letter, says that baptism saves. So since infants and children needed salvation, they needed to be saved by baptism. Mark 16:16, 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 20-21. And in the command of Jesus in Matthew chapter 28, everybody is a subject also of baptism. Verse 19-20. Jesus Jr. said unto them, I have given all authority in heaven and earth. Go then, he commanded the apostles and the church, to all peoples everywhere. Meaning to all peoples, not excluding infants and children, everywhere and everybody. And make them my disciples and baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And teach them all to obey everything I have commanded you. And I will be with you always to the end of the age. Matthew
seconds.
Chapter 28, verse 18-20. So therefore, from these verses alone, it is enough that infant baptism is proved literally in the scriptures, in the Bible, Protestant and Catholic alike. Thank you very much. And once again, good evening, everybody.
All right.
Okay, let's proceed to the 5 minutes first cross.
Okay, maraming salamat po, Bro Alvin. Wala po tayong mga tanong dito at saka comment. So set po natin ang ating time.
For 5 minutes, first cross from the negative to the to me to affirmative.
Okay. Ayan.
Okay.
So, 5 minutes ang ating cross-examination. Okay, simulan po natin, Bro Alvin.
Yes.
Sige, alright, ba, unang tanong po, Bro Alvin, ano po ba para sa iyo yung purpose ng baptism?
Number one, the purpose of baptism according to Christ's words himself, Mark 16:16, believe and be baptized and you will be saved. So, every person, adult and children, should be baptized because it is a requirement for salvation. Mark 16:16, and Peter again repeats it letter by letter that it is needed for salvation in 1 Peter 3:20-21. The water now means baptism, which now saves you. So baptism saves, and children need also salvation, 1 Peter 2:2, so that they will be given spiritual milk of the Holy Spirit to grow up into salvation. So that is why we baptize infants according to the scriptures. Acts 2:38-39, infantes, meaning infants, small and little children are subject for baptism. Acts 2:38-39.
Okay. Alright. Si, bakit po ba si Jesus na hindi siya na-baptize no infant pa siya?
Actually, that is your position with the Protestant Church. But in the Catholic Church, his circumcision in Luke 2:21-24 and presentation to the temple already represents baptism birthday for us Catholics in the Christian Church, because St. Paul tells that in the New Testament, the baptism of Jesus is now the equivalent to baptism for infants and children, and the Catholic people in the New Testament, where in the scriptures, Colossians 2:11-12, let us just read the TV, today's English version of the Protestant Bible. This verse, before I give back to you the microphone. Colossians chapter 2, if you also follow, dear friends, at itong mga listeners, 2:11-12. Scripture says, in union with Christ, you were circumcised, not with a circumcision that is made by human beings, but with a circumcision made by Christ, which consists of being freed from the power of the sinful devil. What circumcision? For when you were baptized, in Christ, you were baptized with Christ. And in baptism, you were also raised with Christ through faith in the active power of God who raised him from the dead. Colossians 2:11-12. So baptism of the Christian's birthday is now the fulfillment of the figure of the circumcision of Jesus when he is still 8 days old as a baby. Luke 2:21-23. Colossians 2:11-12.
Okay, so yung infants ba, sabi mo kanina yung baptism ay para po sa salvation. Yung infants
yes.
ba kung mabaptize siya, save na ba po siya?
Of course, because baptism saves, Mark 16:16, letter by letter. And then 1 Peter 3:20-21, verse 21 is very categorical and direct statement. Baptism now saves you. So when an infant is already baptized and he is saved, and he is already baptized and he died, then the Holy Spirit is already given to him by virtue of baptism. His sins are forgiven, the original sin or the sinful nature inherited from Adam and Eve. And the day of death, he will surely go to heaven, because that is the promise of Christ in John 3:5-7. Unless a man be born of water and spirit, the Catholic Church means that baptism, he shall enter the kingdom of God. John 3:5-7. It refers to baptism in the context of John 3:26-28. So baptism saves the infants and children when they are baptized. That is the biblical stand.
Okay, so kung paano po yung infants na nabaptized tapos paglaki niya nagka-commit siya ng mortal sin?
So we once again have another sacrament for that, because baptism was only given once. Ephesians 4:5. Only one baptism, both Protestant and Catholic agree. Isa lang talaga isang beses ang baptismo. Kahit sa Baptist Church, you cannot be baptized. Magkasala kayo, magpabaptismo ka sa pastor. No, it cannot be done. So also the Catholic Church, only once, Ephesians 4:5. So when the children already grown up, they commit sin, they go to the sacrament of penance. Because the scriptures I have read make penance according to Acts 2:38 in Douay-Rheims Version, Holy Bible. Penance means the institution by Christ of the power to forgive sins given to the apostles and the successors of the bishops and the priests. John 20:21-23. I give you now the power of the Holy Spirit, whom forever you have forgiven their sins, they shall be forgiven. Whomsoever you shall not forgive their sins, they shall not be forgiven. John 20:21-23. So for adults, madre, after baptism is the sacrament of confession or penance.
Okay, yung binanggit mo kanina, Bro Alvin, sa Acts chapter 2 verse number 39.
Yes.
Saan ba yung baptism? Doon ba sa 39 o sa 41? Verse 41 or verse 39 po?
When we talk about the subject of baptism, meaning every one of you, and the command is all, according to Matthew 28:19, all nations, all people, Mark 16:16. So the fulfillment of such a command is also the subject is includes everybody, meaning baptism is written in Acts 2:38, but is also promised to the children in verse 39, which in the French Bible is infantes, infants, meaning small children in the Greek technois, or little children or infants, mga sucklings. So they are also subject madre, and they are not excluded in baptism according to the word of God, letter by letter, if we accept the word of God.
Okay, time na po. Yun po ang ating cross-examination. Alright, so andito, happy listening sila Glenn Iducel at sina Tangkawan, Bibi Rose, na join sa atin ngayon. Si June Paterno Lombes Mercado, Erwin Ibarita, and also Makong Mangyaw is also listening sa ating debate ngayon. So again, sa mga nahuli, yes, sa mga nahuli po, ang ating talakayan ngayong gabi or debate po ay about infant baptism, and natapos na po sa 10 minutes po yung natapos na presentation ng affirmative side si Brother Alvin Gitamundok ng Roman Catholic Church. So ngayon po, ako na po ang mag-nigar or kaya sa negative side. Ako na po yung
first negative stand
at 10 minutes. Okay, Bro Alvin?
Sige.
Okay.
Okay. Sige. Thank you, Brother.
Alright, so simulan po natin. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, maraming salamat po sa inyong pakikinig o pag-watch sa atin ngayon. Now, yung infant baptism po, yung ating topic ngayong gabi. So, malinaw na sinabi ng ating katunggali ngayong gabi na si Bro Alvin, yung mga explanation po niya sa kanyang side na about infant baptism. Now, meron tayong mga iilan ng mga points na ating i-discuss ngayong gabi patungkol po sa kanyang presentation. Now, una-una po yung naiintindihan ko o nakuha ko yung kanyang verse na binasa sa Acts chapter 2 nung si Apostol Pedro po ay nagsalita. The first time na na-open po yung gospel sa the day of Pentecost, that St. Peter preached about this baptism in verse number 38. The Bible says, "Then Peter said unto them, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ." Remember po, na meron pong sinabi si Peter na repent and be baptized. So yung infant po, hindi po makarepent yan kasi yung infant nga hindi niya pa alam, no, he or she is in the innocent stage. Hindi pa po makarepent yan, at sinabi ni Peter dito na repent and be baptized. Hindi naman sinabi niya baptize lang, but you have to repent and be baptized for the remission of sins. and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. And binasa niyo po yung 39, for the promise is unto you and your children. Malinaw po yung mensahe ni Pedro na yung promise about the Holy Ghost is unto the adults and the children. Kasi yung mga adults, pag nawala yun, kasama ng mga children. Meron kasing mga promise na para lang po sa ating mga adults. Dito sa Biblia, may mga promises dito na para lamang sa specific na tao, pero hindi po sa lahat ng tao. So ito palang Holy Ghost na pagtanggap ng Holy Ghost is even though mawala na yung mga magulang, yung children at sa ibang mga generation, sila po ay kasama sa promise. Ngunit, mga kapatid, mga kaibigan, yung baptism po na naganap, nasa verse 41 pa po. Yun po ay mensahe muna ni Pedro, pero yung sa 41, yun pong na makikita natin kung ano po yung mga binautismuhan. Sabi po ng Biblia, then they that gladly receive His word were baptized. How do we know na walang infant? Kasi the Bible says, yung nabautismuhan, yung mga that receive the word gladly. Hindi naman po makareceive yung infant. So, there is no sense na merong infant po dyan. The only verse there is about the children to receive the promise of the Holy Ghost. Meaning po, na sa magulang at sa mga bata, kahit ilang generation po, ang promise ng Holy Ghost ay para po sa lahat. So, hindi po lahat ay babautismuhan, kasi naman, yung mabautismuhan dito ay yung yaon lamang mga tumanggap ng kanilang salita. Now, according also to the Catholic answers po ng article ni Scott Hahn, ginamit po yung Acts chapter 16 na hindi naman ginamit ni Bro Alvin kasi maliit po ng oras natin. Now, verse number, yung 16 ng Acts, yung Philippian jailer, sabi nila, meron daw infant dito kasi binanggit yung household. Tingnan po natin mga kapatid, sabi ng Biblia sa Acts 16:30, and brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? The Bible says, and they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy house. And then the Bible says in verse 33, and he took them the same hour the night, and washed their stripes, and was baptized, all he and all his straightway. Sabi nila, yung meron daw infant dito kasi household. Mga kaibigan, hindi naman po lahat ng household may infants. Sa amin nga, ngayon, sa aming neighborhood, hindi ko iilan lang yung mga may infant. Hindi naman lahat may infant. Pero, napakalinaw sa verse na ito in verse number 34. Bakit walang infant sa household ng Philippian jailer? Because in verse 34, and when he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them, rejoice, believing in God with all his house. So lahat naman sila na sumampalataya, naniniwala sa Diyos. So that means yung infant hindi naman po kasama sa naniniwala. So mga kapatid, sabi ko kanina, tinanong ko si Bro Alvin, ano ba ang purpose ng baptism? Sabi niya, for salvation po. Sabi ni David nung Old Testament, sabi niya, and David, yung si David, but now he is dead, wherefore should I fast? Can I bring him back again? I shall go to him and he shall not return to me. Malinaw po sa Biblia, yung infant, kasi pag hindi na bautismuhan, hindi po nabibiniyagan, malinaw po naman na sa langit po pupunta.
What bakit po?
Sorry po. Second Samuel chapter 12 verse number 23, yung namatay po yung first na anak ni David kay Bathsheba. Sabi ni David, I shall go to him, but he shall not return unto me. So sabi ni si David, alam natin na anak siya ng Diyos, so that means he is going to heaven. Now according to verse Matthew chapter 19 verse number 23, sabi ni Jesus Christ, verily I say unto you that a rich 19:14, but Jesus said, suffer little children and forbid them not to come unto me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. Sa kanila po yung kaharian ng Diyos, sabi ng Biblia. So sabi na niya 2010 ni Pope Benedict XVI na limbo does not exist, sabi niya. At pwede nang hindi binyagan yung mga bata. Mga kapatid, sabi ng Biblia, ang bata po ay isang inosente. Kahit po meron, of course, sabi ng CCC ni Scott Hahn na yung bata, meron tinatawag na original sin. Tama naman na merong fallen nature yung bata. Wala tayong disagreement diyan. Pero mga kapatid, sabi ng Biblia, kahit ang bata naman, yung Diyos naman, hindi po naman siya hindi po niya paparusahan yung mga bata in the innocent states, kasi sabi ng Biblia, sabi ni David, pupunta ako sa kanya, hindi siya babalik sa akin. Sabi ni Jesus Christ, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. Even nga, sabi na nga, ang Biblia niya, nga ang nagsasabi na yung kaharian ng Diyos ay sa mga bata, ay children nga itong ginamit, hindi naman infants. So, more pa yung mga infants. So, ladies and gentlemen, sabi din sa Biblia na according to baptism, ano po yung unang requirements po. Malinaw po sa Biblia yung Acts chapter 8 na andito po yung requirements ng baptism. Sabi ng Biblia, nung si Philip at yung eunuch, sabi ng eunuch ko na nung na-witnessan siya ni Philip, nalaman niya si Jesus Christ at sumampalataya siya kay Jesus. Sabi ng Philip, they came unto a certain water in Acts 8:36, and the eunuch said, see, here is water. What doth hinder me to be baptized? Ano po ba yung makahadlang sa akin upang ako ay mabinyagan, mabautismuhan? Sabi ni Philip, if thou believest with all thine heart, thou mayest. Isa lang po yung requirements. Unang-una po, if you believe the Lord Jesus Christ, thou mayest. Pwede, kasi merong if, that means merong kondisyon. Ano po ba yung kondisyon upang mabautismuhan? If you believe with all your heart. So, mga kapatid, di ko naman sasabihin na yung baptism ng infant ay sin. O kaya, para po sa akin, yung infant baptism po na ginagawa ng mga ating mga kaibigang Katoliko, para po wala po siyang purpose actually regarding that about this context o sabi ng Biblia. Kasi po, yung bata naman, yung infant, kung mamamatay sa langit, pupunta, at kung lumaki siya at then meron siyang mortal sin, then ma-impyerno pa rin siya. So walang gamit po ang infant baptism. So yun lang po.
Time na, Brother?
Time.
Okay, thank you, Brother. So set the time.
Ang dami mga dito, mayroong mga nag-comment, Robin. You can also read kung gusto mo. Sabi ni John Robinson Reyes, linaw mag-explain ni Bro Alvin. Okay.
Thank you.
So si yun po ang sabi ng isa nating kaibigan. Sabi po dito ng Mark Soralta, ito po ay Bisaya. Babasahin ba natin po ito, Bro Alvin?
Ikaw lang bahala, Bro.
Mark, sorry Mark, hindi. Ako ang operator ngayon, Mark. Nindot na atangan, bro, sabi ni Bro Irwin. At sino po yung Wala pa si Vince Ferrer sa cabin mayong gabi sa tanan. Okay. At good team bro Vince. Ni-replyan po naman ito ni Brother Irwin. So, yung lang po yung mga nag-comment Brother Alvin. So, okay. Wala namang mga tanong, wala namang ibang comment. So, importante. So, mga kaibigan, mga kabisdak, dito po tayo sa 5 minutes cross examination ng affirmative sa negative. So, simulan natin, Bro Alvin.
5 minutes na kaset na, Bro Ray, okay?
Ito po.
So, first question, Bro Ray. My verses that I have already shared to you as foundation for infant baptism for us Catholics includes everyone and everybody, all nations, all people. Mark 16:16, Matthew 28:9-18-20, John 3:5-7. Now, my question is very direct, categorical. Please answer me. If there is a Bible verse that exclude infants in baptism or a command from Christ or the apostles, a chapter and verse in the scriptures in the Bible, Old and New Testament, that forbids infants to be baptized. Is there a chapter and verse for that or no? If no, you can tell me na wala, letra po letra. And then you qualify.
Opo. Wala po. Wala po tayong mababasang letra por letra na forbids infant baptism. So, bakit po natin nalalaman yung walang infant baptism? Kasi po, alam natin yung requirements na kailangan po sila po ay sumampalataya. At pagkatapos po yung Matthew 28 na kinote din sa atin ng kaibigan natin Bro Alvin, sabi dito sa Matthew 28, oo nga lahat nga ng tao, pero sabi ng verse 19, go ye therefore and teach all nations. So you have to teach first all nations and then baptizing them in the name of the Father. So, malalaman po natin kahit walang letra por letra kung ano po yung mga tao na babautismuhan. You need to teach them first. And then, sabi ng Acts chapter 2, kung they receive the word with gladness or they believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the moment that they believe, then pwede po silang babautismuhan. Yun po, wala pong word for word, Bro Alvin.
Okay, Bro Ray, thank you very much for your answer. Now, my next question is, based on your verse that you have quoted, Matthew 19:14, you highlighted the words of Christ for the kingdom of heaven is for such. But the precedence is the statement of Christ which says, suffer that little children, also the infants, and forbid them not to come to me. So now, Padre, what is your right and authority to be forbidden, to forbid infants and children to be baptized when Christ commanded, do not forbid them, suffer not them to forbid them to come to me. And baptism for us, Catholics and Protestants, is also coming to Jesus Christ. Okay. So what is your right and authority, Padre, to forbid infants to be baptized when Christ said, do not forbid infants? Matthew 19:14. Please answer me your question.
Okay, yung authority po natin ay yung Biblia. Kasi po, alam mo naman natin na kami as a Baptist, we believe what the Bible says. So, yung authority po namin, Biblia po, Bro Alvin, hindi po sa akin, but ang Biblia po nagsasabi. Sabi ng Biblia, suffer the little children, or this is the old English word of allow. The little children, and forbid them not to come unto me.
Mm.
They are the one coming to Jesus Christ because yung mga disipulo dito sa context, yung mga bata, hindi nila pinapalapit kay Jesus Christ kasi parang magulo yung mga bata. But sabi ng Biblia, ito mga children, they have to come and pwede po silang, they have to come to themselves, but infant baptism, Bro Alvin, hindi po sila yung pumaroon kay Jesus Christ, it is their parents. So wala pong alam, kaalam-alam yung infant. Dito, yung mga children, gustong pumasok, gustong pumaroon kay Jesus Christ, pinipigilan ng mga disipulo, kaya sabi ni Jesus Christ, forbid them not. It's not about baptism, but it's about coming to Jesus Christ when He is just on earth.
Next question, Brother Ray. In the context of Matthew 18:10-14, Jesus said, "See that you do not despise one of these little children, little ones, for I say to you that our angels in heaven always see the face of my Father who is in heaven." And in verse 14, "Even so, it is at the will of the Father in heaven that one of these children, this little one, should perish." Now, para hindi sila mapahamak, Brother Ray, so ito pala mga children, pwede pang mapahamak. Now, why did you forbid infant baptism when it is necessary for salvation for infants, Brother Ray? When you affirm that the children are not forbidden in Matthew chapter 19, verse 14. Question is, are they really forbidden or not? Which of the two?
Unang-una, sabi ko naman kanina not na forbidden. Hindi answer naman, yes, hindi naman yan, okay. Hindi not naman forbidden. Po tayo na forbid. Ang aking sinabi po, malinaw po kanina, na yung infant baptism pala ay wala pong kabuluhan yan. Kasi sabi ng Biblia, yung mga children, if they, yung infant, kung mamatay, mamamatay man sila, as infant, kahit walang baptism, pupunta naman sila sa langit, kaparehas po ng anak ni David na infant pa namatay. At sabi ni Kristo po naman na for of such is the kingdom of heaven. Yung ma-perish po yung mga children dito sa Matthew
18:14, yes,
Matthew 18.
They still have a chance to perish if they are not baptized.
Naturally, they perish here is also about, kasi yung mga bata pwede natin turuan, pero kung hindi natin tuturuan yan, it will, they will perish if the moment that they come into the age of accountability, Bro Alvin.
Okay, next question.
No, time na po tayo.
At time lang 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Bilis naman.
Time na po tayo mga kapatid. Kanina pa, 5 minutes na po yung cross-examination. So, siguro mga 4 lang yung mga tanong mga kaibigan. So,
3 to 4 questions.
Meron tayong rebuttal, Bro Alvin. Ano po yung ilang oras po ang rebuttal?
10 minutes pa rin.
10 rin ang rebuttal. Tapos, summary po, 5 minutes po after this. Okay, yes. So wala namang pong bagong comment, Bro Alvin.
Okay.
Meron po tayong mga 6 na nakikinig or nanonood sa atin ngayon. So okay, so 10 minutes po. I-set po muna natin yung time.
Sige, Bro.
Meron kang sasabihin, Bro. You can do it now.
Okay na. I'll just okay. Wait for the setting of the time.
Okay, the time is set. And dito po tayo sa rebuttal period, mga kapatid. 10 minutes po. Bro Alvin, go ahead.
Thank you very much, Brother Ray. And now, ladies and gentlemen, listeners, you have already listened to the questions that I have posted to Brother Ray, and it's also his direct answer to my question. Especially, he used Matthew 19:14, on which he highlighted the words of God, "The kingdom of heaven is for such." Does that mean that the kingdom of heaven is not also for adults? Because the kingdom of heaven is for everybody. That is why Christ did not forbid children to come to Him. Matthew 19:14, if we read in context, in Matthew 18:10-14, it reads, muna sa Matthew 19:14, 18 muna tayo, 10 hanggang 14, "See that you despise not of these little ones, these little children, for I say to you that there are angels in heaven always see the face of my Father who is in heaven." So we are told not to despise children. Kasi bakit? If we despise children, especially giving them baptism, we would not give them baptism. No infant baptism at all. In verse 14, Christ warned us, "Even so it is the will of your Father who is in heaven that these little ones, these children, should perish." So meaning perish means damnation. They will not be saved. That is what the Bible says when we make perish, when the scriptures stated, children will perish. That is scriptural, Matthew 18:10-14. So that's why in Matthew 19:14, in context of Matthew 18:10-14, the children are not forbidden to be baptized. Anybody who forbids, this that is the enemy of Christ, because they didn't want the children to come to Jesus to be blessed. And in 15, "And we had imposed sons upon them, he departed from thence." Meaning the blessing is given to the children. The Christ rebuked the apostles. So this is a rebuke by the Uber position, the Baptist Church, another non-Catholic religion who prohibits or forbids infant baptism to infants? Because my last question, if there is still time, do you believe Brad Ray in Mark 16:16 and 1 Peter 3:20-21 and John 3:5-7 that baptism is important for salvation because baptism saves? Yes or no? Yun sana ang lahat sa tanong ko. Kasi dito, letra po letra, kailangan talaga ng salvation kasi maperish pa yung infants eh. Kaya nga, ang baptism is also for infants according to Acts 2:38-39 sa Greek technois, children, meaning in the French, infantes, meaning small children or sucklings and babies. So, they are also subject for baptism. And Brad Ray has failed to negate that point. He went to Acts 16:15-16, Acts 16:31-34, which I have not mentioned in my first affirmative stand. What is very clear is, in 1 Peter 3:20, he did not rebut this, we're saved by the water. What water? Which is the baptism which now saves you, according to St. Peter, Mark 16:16. And 1 Peter 3:20-21, the scriptures is clear. So he who forbids infant baptism is against the commands of God because it is all-inclusive. The commands of God for baptism, Mark 16:15-16, the whole creation. Babies are also creation by God. And then Matthew 28:18-20, make disciples of all nations. All nations includes infants. That covers already the infants. Among households, even though there are households have no infants, but all nations of the world covered, everybody, all infants are also considered. So, Brad Ray has failed to disprove my verses, and he goes to verses which is in Old Testament, to Samuel 12:23. There is not yet still baptism as an institution by God. In the New Testament, it's still Old Testament. So, there is no trouble with Old Testament verses. We have to deal with the New Testament verses dealing on baptism, because baptism, according to St. Paul, says, so there is no difference between Jews and Gentiles. It is through faith that all of you are God's children in union with Christ. All should be God's children, including infants ito, kasi all eh. Yung all is inclusive, not exclusive. Paano? So that we can be God's children, not only our children and infants are our own children as parents, but our infants and babies and sucklings and children, little children, who are our children, are also children of God. How? Galatians 3:26-27, you were baptized into union with Christ, and now you are clothed, so to speak, with the life of Christ himself. Galatians 3:26-27, meaning the babies and infants, there is no distinction, there is no discrimination. They are also subject for baptism so that they will be baptized in union with Christ, be clothed with Christ. That is not forbidding that Christ would bless them with the blessing of baptism. The ultimate blessing is the Holy Spirit. Matthew 19:14-15, Christ blessed the children, and now in the institution of baptism, and Acts 2:38-39, babies and infants were also baptized because there is no other gift that is much more precious than the gift of the Holy Spirit, which are also given to infants. Now, Brad Ray has not demolished my commentary on what is read in the letter for letter, literal, Saint Bible, Bible in the French Bible, in Acts 2:38-39. It was Elizabeth Doldon sent Spirit, meaning you will receive the Holy Spirit in verse 39. Carla promets es por vos infants, meaning this is the promise not only for you, but also for your infants, literally, Acts 2:38-39. Kaya nga umabot sa verse 41 ng 3,000 kasi kasamang infants. Kasi how can you baptize by pouring? Mabilis ang baptism, hindi yun paglubog sa mga malalakilan kasi hindi mo makukuha ang 3,000 katao in verse 41. So they gladly receive kasi nireceive ng parents. Kasama na din ng mga babies, mga anak, according to Acts 2:39, infants. So that is the primary contention, which also fulfilled in Joel 2:16, which also Brad Ray have forgotten to rebut in his first negative stand. In Joel 2:16, are infants excluded with the church to be sanctified? Gather together the people. The Wireless Version Holy Bible, Joel 2:16. sanctify the church. O ito yung church, Christian church. Sa Acts 2:38 ito rin. How to be sanctified? Kasama bang infants? Assemble the ancients o malalaki. Acts 2:38. Kasama kayo mga lalaki to be forgiven by the Holy Spirit and repent. Pero sa mga maliliit, gather also the little ones and the infants and them that suck at the breast. Mga sucklings. Acts Joel 2:16 fulfilled letter by letter. Acts 2:17-20, verse 38-39 by the Acts of the Apostles. Kaya mga gawa ng mga apostolan eh. Nagbinyag talaga sila ng mga children, babies and infants. So hindi to ma-rebut ni Brad Ray because this is already literal. When I ask him a question, a very simple question, Brad Ray, my verses that the command of Christ about baptism, the requirement and importance of baptism and salvation is very clear. Mark 16:16, Matthew 28:19-20, John 3:5-7, and many verses that I've quoted. Now, in your, as a Bible Baptist, as a Protestant, where can you find the chapter and verse that baptism is forbidden, is not allowed for infants? And you affirm, no, there is no such verse forbidding or not allowing infant baptism. No, letter for letter in the scriptures. So meaning, my stand, I have here letter for letter, inclusive of infants, and you have none. So my stand is the one correct biblical way and method of salvation. And then, you did not negate that baptism is not for salvation. You said it is not important for salvation, but mind you, Brother Ray, we have to listen to the scriptures, not to your statement or your interpretation. You said categorically, baptism is not important for salvation. It is already on the record. I have already written it in my paper.
Two minutes.
In the scriptures.
2 minutes, bro.
Yes, Brother Ray, thank you. You were saved by water, which is the baptism, which now saves you. Is that not important? Water's baptism saves you. According to Peter, 1 Peter 3:20-21, according to Brother Ray, water baptism cannot save infant, meaning it is not important for salvation. It has no salvific value. Mark 16:16, Christ, the words of Christ himself, he who believes and is baptized shall be saved. Oh, so baptism is also a requirement to be saved. And it is a requirement. Tapos sabihin mo, Brother Ray, kay Kristo, kung nandun ka pa kay Kristo, mga baptism, sabihin, Panginoon, hindi naman importante ang baptism, just faith in you. No, you will be corrected by Jesus and the apostles, especially St. Peter. Mark 16:15-16, 1 Peter 3:20-21, kasi nga mga infants yung mga bibigyan din ng salvation, kaya they can also be lost without baptism. Matthew 18:14, and then 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 2, as newborn babies. Oh, ito sa Greek blephos, maliliit talaga mga bata, maliliit sucklings, desire that rational milk, sabi ni Peter ha, 1 Peter 2:2. This is in commentary of Acts 2, verse 38-39. Infants or little children, without guile, that you have that rational milk from the Holy Spirit, the spiritual milk, yun yung Holy Spirit, Acts 2, 38, that thereby you may also grow like infants unto salvation. Kaya nga pa, patubuin, palaguin, palakasin, yung mga babies pa, mula mo ng baby tayo, binigyan tayo agad para matanggap natin ng Holy Spirit sa Jesus Christ, we are blessed with the Holy Spirit. By the grace of God, we will grow in faith, hope, and love. Romans 5:1-5. So we will be saved from infanthood. Because if infants who die without baptism, they can perish. Matthew 18:14, Jesus is the one who told that. That's why very important is baptism for salvation, especially for infants. And John 3:5-7, Brother Ray has also not rebutted many verses. All the verses that I've quoted, he made other verses that I did not quote.
Time like, na po.
Okay. Thank you very much. 3:5-7.
10 minutes is gone, mga kaibigan, mga kapatid, mga kabisdak. At maraming salamat po, Bro Alvin, sa iyong rebuttal stand at 10 minutes. At wala pong bago pa rin.
The same pa rin.
Alright. So, tuloy-tuloy po tayo. Anyway, after po sa aming summary, pwede po kayong magtanong sa akin o kaya kay Bro Alvin o meron kayong mga comment o ano po yung naiintindihan nyo, ano po yung gusto nyong malaman or clarification po. So pwede po nyong itanong yan at meron tayong just a little time for open forum bro, bro Alvin, na ba?
Yes, ano? We will give them a little
time. Okay.
So, Bertrick, can you set the time for your cross 5 minutes to me? I am already
Meron pa, meron pa palang 5 minutes na cross?
Yes, 5 minutes cross. Your last cross to me as negative.
Ah, okay. So, meron pang cross-examination po.
Second cross, 5 minutes.
Second cross, okay. 5 minutes. Okay, start po.
Sige, Robin.
Okay. Now, sabi po sa rebuttal mo kanina na yes, yung the very gift po, yung pinaka-importante gift ng matanggap ng isang tao, yung Holy Spirit.
Yes, of course.
Sabi po ng John chapter 7 verse 39 na yung promise po ng Holy Spirit ay matanggap ng mga sumampalataya. Aminin mo ba ito? Tama ba ito, Bro Alvin, o hindi?
Yes, I will affirm it. In John 7:39, I will read, Jesus said this about the Spirit, for those who believe in Him were going to receive. At that time, the Spirit had not yet been given, because Jesus had not been raised to glory. But the fulfillment of this birthday in Acts 2:38-39 includes children, and does not include children, because in the Greek, French Bible, Le Saint Bible, and also in the Greek, Technois, the same, the meaning is infants, infantes, meaning the infants and little children, newborn babies, are also subject for salvation through baptism. And this is very clear that really in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2, today's English version reads that you should also, like little infants, should drink the spiritual milk, the Holy Spirit, so that you may grow into salvation. First Catholic Epistle of St. Peter the Apostle, kaya nagbinyag kami, Brother Ray, isang manifest because they can still be perished. Matthew 18:14, with the baptism, they'll go to hell. So they cannot see the face of God. John 3:5-7. So infant baptism is very important for salvation. Mark 16:16 and 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 22-21, Brother Ray. It's very biblical.
So in-affirm mo yung John 7:39 na sabi ng Biblia, na yung makatatanggap ng Holy Spirit yung lang sumampalataya. Sumampalataya ba yung mga infant, Bro Alvin?
Actually, if we read the scriptures, infants have also internal or innate faith according to Christ in Matthew 18:6. If we read the scriptures, but read, if anyone should cause one of these children, these little ones, to lose his faith in me, it would be better for that person to have a large millstone tied around his neck. Kaya nga, we should not forbid infants and little children, Matthew 19:14, in context of Matthew 18:10-14, because without baptism, they can perish. Mark 16:16, they will not be saved. So meaning, infants have also innate faith according to Christ in Mark 9:49-47, Matthew 18:6, letra po letra, and they're given baptism for the gift of the Holy Spirit by St. Peter, 1 Peter 2:2. Infants to grow to salvation, because salvation is needed, baptism is needed for salvation. 1 Peter 3:20-21, baptism now saves you. You there includes infants. That Peter didn't say baptism now saves you, the grown-ups alone, or the adults, and only for adults, not excluding children and infants, but right. So scriptures is very clear, it is the Catholic position, and that's does not subscribe to the Protestant Baptist position.
Okay, karugtong po sa tanong na yan na bago mo lang nabanggit yung 1 Peter chapter 2.
Verse 2.
1 Peter, hindi po, yung 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 21. Yung
yes.
Now baptism saves
you.
You. Sa ibang version, like the King James version, is saves us.
Yes.
So sabi ng Biblia dito, saves you, and then may binasa ka pa kanina na Galatians. Sino ba ang sinabihan ni Peter dito po? Kasama mo bang infants na sinulatan sa Biblia?
Of course, but Ray, because I quoted 1 Peter 2:2. Just like newborn babies, so kasama yung newborn babies, binigyan ng baptism ito eh. Acts 2:38-39, inclusive, desire that spiritual milk, that thereby you may grow into salvation. So the context of the whole Bible, not only in the specific verse, 1 Peter 3:20, because it is requirement for salvation, include infants. where the word infants is Acts 2:38-39, letropoleta, infantes, in the Greek technois, little children or sucklings and babies are infants. And in 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 2 in context, infants pa rin. And then 1 Peter 3:20-21, needed and necessary for salvation. So we include that way because we do not forbid baptism for infants because Christ would rebuke you if you forbid it. Matthew 19:14, Matthew 18:10-14, and many verses in the Bible.
So last na tanong, 36 seconds. Sabi mo kanina yung Mark 16:16, He that believeth and is baptized.
Yes.
Pwede ba nating bautismuhan yung hindi nag-believe, Bro Alvin?
As I've told you with your first previous question, children has already faith according to Jesus and according to you. Matthew 18:6, Mark 9:47-49, and many verses in the Bible, that little children and sucklings have also innate faith because it is a gift of God to them. And then they are to receive only, because they have already faith, they have already to receive only baptism. That's why Mark 16:16 does not include infants, but on the other hand, it includes infants, Matthew 28:18-20, all nations includes. Kaya lahat ng mga bansa, eh, mga bata, kasama sa household, kasama lang bansa eh. Kaya yun ang punto namin, and they are subject, letropoletra, Acts 2:38-39, 1 Peter 2:2, and necessary for salvation, 1 Peter 3:20-21. If you exclude infants, Padre, meaning you are against the words of God because you are forbidding infant baptism which leads them to salvation according to the Bible. Meaning you are anti-biblical and your stand is not Christian, because Christian stand is Galatians 3:26-27. All of us children, God's children, pati na mga baby natin, but they are God's children, to be clothed and to be with union with Christ through baptism.
Time na po. Okay, so tapos na po yung 5 minutes, mga kaibigan, mga kapatid, at mga kabisdat. So, 10 minutes rebuttal po tayo. Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen po, narinig nyo po yung talakayan ngayong gabi about infant baptism at Bro Alvin Gitamundok po ng Roman Catholic Church, affirmative at yung pong kanyang mga rebuttal. Narinig nyo also yung mga verses. Malinaw po naman yung mga verses na bilanggit ng ating kaibigan po. So you can check the verses. And then kung meron po kayong mga tanong, clarifications po at mga objections, you can do it later. Or kahit ngayon, kung meron kayong tanong sa akin o kaya tanong kay Bro Alvin, i-comment nyo po sa comment section. Babasahin po natin yan. At tatanungin po natin kung meron kayong mga tanong, sasagutin po natin kung sino po yung tatanungin niyo po. So, ang ating oras po ngayon, alas 10:45 na po. Okay, 10:45 p.m. ang ating oras ngayong gabi. At ready na po ang iyong ang ating 10 minutes na rebuttal po ng ating negative yung lingkod, Brother Ray, na Fentes ng Baptist Church. Okay? So, antayin po natin si Bro Alvin.
Sige, Brother, you can start.
Okay, so I can start now, friends and mga kabisdak, sa ating 10 minutes rebuttal. Okay? Simulan ko pa, sisimulan ko pa ko na yung oras. Okay? Now, ladies and gentlemen, narinig nyo po, binalik-balikan ni Bro Alvin yung Mark 16:16. Sabi ng Biblia, malinaw na malinaw, na he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Sabi niya, kasama po dito ang infant. Kasi sabi din ng kanyang verse kanina in Matthew 18:6, yung infant daw, infantes, dahil mayroong French Bible. Mga kaibigan, isa pong pwede po naman nating basahin e intindihin yung Biblia, napakalinaw po naman. Sabi ng verse niya, babasahin niyo po or basahin niyo pong mabuti in Matthew chapter 18 verse number 6. Sabi ng Biblia, "But whoso shall offend one of these little ones." So, ladies and gentlemen, paano po i-offend yung infant? So, Christ is talking about children. Yung kasing mga children, di natin alam kung anong mga ano dito eh, anong mga edad ng mga children na ito. Pero, malinaw that whoso shall offend. So, alam natin na hindi po, hinding-hindi ma-offend yung mga infant. So, these are children kasi sabi ng Biblia, kung hindi po kayo maniniwala o sumampalataya katulad ng mga bata, yun ang mga bata na pwede nating i-baptize. Nagbabaptize po naman kami ng children eh. Yung mga bata na nag-profess na at nag-believe kay Jesus Christ. Believe is trusting. In Greek, it's pisteo. It's trusting the Lord Jesus Christ. How can an infant trust the Lord Jesus Christ in His innocency, ladies and gentlemen? So, hindi po yan, wala pong basihan ang infant baptism. So, iisa-isahin natin kasi rebuttal period na po ito, hindi na ito presentation. Sabi dito in 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 2, binanggit niya po. Sabi ng Biblia, as newborn babes, infant nga. Pero sabi ng Biblia, as, when you read the Bible, ladies and gentlemen, when you come across the word as, always and always substitute it with the word similar. Similar or liken, ladies and gentlemen, isa pong prinsipyo ng pag-interpret ng Biblia, as na ang sinabi, as newborn babes. Bakit po magiging isang parang bata po tayo? Sabi kasi ng Biblia, desire the sincere milk of the word. Kasi yung mga bata, they desire the milk, always desiring the milk. Pero sabi ni Peter, alam po naman natin yung pinaka-logic po kasi mga kaibigan, mga kapatid at mga kabisdak. Yung sinulatan unang-una sa lahat ay mga hindi infant. Bakit? Bakit? Hindi naman makakabasa ng epistle yung mga infant, ladies and gentlemen. Yung sinabihan dito, yung mga believers. Kasi sabi ng Biblia, unang-una, verse 1, wherefore laying aside all malice, all guile, hypocrisies, envies, wala pong bata makakagawa dito, wala na po, wala pong infant ang gagawa nito, kundi yung mga may edad, even children that they are that's already believing the Lord Jesus Christ, as newborn babes nga eh. Bakit? Gusto ni Pedro, ni Apostle Pedro, na tayo po ay mag-uuhaw sa salita ng Diyos. As newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word that ye may grow thereby. Upang tayo, ang ating pananampalataya ay lumaki at lumaki mga kaibigan, dapat po tayo ay always hungry in the word of God as newborn babes. Kasi always hungry sila ng milk. Hindi mo yan bibigyan ng gatas isang araw, iiyak ng iiyak na yan. So, just like that, because so many people, so many Christians, they don't care about the word of God, hindi sila nauuhaw. Sabi ni Pedro, as newborn babes, na mauuhaw tayo. So, hindi po yan isang example din ng, hindi yan support ng infant baptism. Yung 1 Peter chapter 3 verse number 21, sabi niya, because baptism saves us. The Bible says, the like figure whereunto even baptism doth also now saves us. Kasama po si Pedro. Kung you ang sinasabihan ng ibang Biblia, then of course, yung mga tao na sinulatan yung makakabasa ng epistle, hindi yung infant. Pero ano po ba yung saving ng baptism in verse 21? malinaw po, pag puputulin mo yung verse na yan, malinaw na makakaligtas ang baptism. Pero kung hindi mo yan puputulin, napakalinaw na sabi ni Peter, not the putting away of the filth of the flesh, but the answer of good conscience toward God. So, ibig sabihin, ladies and gentlemen, yung baptism, makakaligtas yan sa mga sa ating konsensya upang ito po ay ang ating mga konsensya ng mga old sins ay mawawala. So, yan, dapat tayo ma-baptize. Now, hindi po naman ito salvation na topic. Ang topic po natin dito ay infant baptism. Wala pong basihan ang infant baptism kahit saan dito sa Biblia. Yung mga sinasabi niya mga verses, hindi po natin nakikita. And in fact, in sabi po niya kanina, yung Joel, tiningnan ko yung verse, hindi po naman ito baptism. Gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the elders, gather the children, and those that suck the breast, that means infant, you gather them all. Ano pong bang, anong ibig sabihin ng gathering? Bakit po? Babautismuhan po ba sila? Hindi po. Sabi ng Biblia, you gather everything because lahat po ang gusto ng Diyos, lahat po ng tao ay maturuan o kaya isa po itong pagsasabi na lahat ng mga tao po you can gather. Pero ano bang anong sabi ng Biblia? Hindi naman ito baptism. So you can read everything you want to read, pero just a question if that is talking about baptism or in water baptism, it's not talking about baptism, especially the Old Testament. Sabi ng Biblia sa Acts chapter 2 verse 38, the promise is unto you and to the children. So, yung promise of the Holy Ghost. Pero tinanong ko sa kanina, aaminin mo ba, tatanggapin mo yung John 7.39, napakalinaw po yung John 7.39, hindi po matatanggap ang banal na espiritu ng kung sino-sino. Ang sabi ng Biblia, matatanggap ito, isa po itong pangako ng Diyos na matatanggap sa mga taong sumampalataya. Napakalinaw, 7.39. But this spake he of the Spirit which they that believe on him should receive. So, napakalinaw po kung according to first yung Ephesians 1:13, after yung mga epeso nag-believe or sumampalataya kay Kristo, sila po ay nakatanggap. Wala pong nakatanggap na ng banal na espiritu ng bata kasi nga yung bata, sabi ni David, pupunta sa langit yun, namatay ang kanyang anak, pupunta siya doon. Hindi na yun babalik. Tapos si Kristo naman, for of such is the kingdom of heaven, huwag niyong pigilang mga bata na pumarito sa akin kasi sa kanila ang kaharian ng Diyos. Napakalino po na walang basihan yung infant baptism, sabi ng Biblia. Kasi po naman, kung mamamatay yung bata, na na-baptize tapos nakakommit ng for example suicide, yung mortal sin, hindi naman siya maliligtas according to the Catholic doctrines. So ano pong gamit ng infant baptism kung makapagsala pa naman siya ng mga mortal sins? So again, yung loss of salvation a-apply yan sa ganito, so wala talagang gamit. So ladies and gentlemen, kaya nga si Constantine, sinigurado niya na lahat ng kanyang mga sala ay mawawala. That's why he decided to be baptized nung siya ay patapos na yung in his deathbed. Kasi matalino si Constantine. Gusto niya, paano yung mga sala ko pagkatapos ako mabaptize? Hindi naman yon mahuhugasan. So baptize me when I almost died, mga ladies and gentlemen. So yung infant baptism po sa requirements ng baptism na dapat sumampalataya, hindi naman tayo mag-baptize ng mga taong kung sino-sino lang, kahit mga ATS o ano, babaptismuhan sila. Baptism is the inward manifestation of the outward manifestation of the inward faith. Kung tunay kang sumampalataya according to the Bible, if you believe and baptize. If you believe, then you can be baptized. If you don't believe, then you should not be baptized. And infants do not believe, ladies and gentlemen. They are of heaven. If they die, 100%, they will go to heaven from the Bible, David, and Jesus says, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. So, yun lang po mga kapatid. Salamat po at dito po tayo sa last na cross-examination ng affirmative to the negative.
5 minutes.
5 minutes po. Bro Alvin, wala rin tayong babasahin ng comments, so patuloy po tayo.
Sige, Brother, my first question is 2 Timothy, based on 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 15. And because from thy infancy thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which can instruct thee to salvation by the faith which is in Christ Jesus. In the Greek Bible, kai hote hapo blephos hiera grammata, and that from an infancy, the Holy Scriptures you have known. Ngayon sabi mo kanina, ang sulat para lang sa malalaki, hindi sa mga infants eh. Ngayon, Birthday, sino ngayon ang susundin natin? 2 Timothy 3.15, letra po letra, yung sabi mo na sa malalaki lang ang Bible at sa preaching sa Word of God, the Gospel. Sino? Ikaw ang Bible. Choose sa dalawa, then you explain.
Of course, ang Bible. Biblia po ang ating paniniwalaan.
So mali, kan ang Bible para lang sa malalaki. Hindi,
mag-qualify pa po ako ng sagot, okay? Yung 2 Timothy 3.15, Biblia po naman ang ating paniniwalaan, mga kapatid. Sabi kasi ng Biblia, ito si Timothy, isang young preacher po ito, at sinabihan siya ni Pablo, and that from a child. So, yung child po, isang issue ng translation, pero sa Bible po dito, malalaman pa rin.
I'm missing the Greek, but blephos infant talaga, oh.
Malalaman pa rin natin na hindi pa rin infant, kasi sabi ng Biblia, and that from a child, thou hast known the Holy Scripture.
Okay,
how can a child know a Holy Scripture? How can an infant know the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith? So okay, meron pa rin faith dyan.
The Greek English interlinear New Testament, ginamit dito sa Greek word blephos. Ang translation directly sa blephos, wala namang iba, an infant in infancy. Tatanggapin mo ito o hindi? Will you accept this or you will reject this? San sa dalawa? Tanggap po or reject?
Sa ganung tanong po, isa po.
Sagutin mo muna, brother. Tatanggapin mo ba or you will reject this?
Hindi ko tatanggapin sali na yan, kasi meron tayo mga Biblia na mababasihan at hindi po naman yan just word, pero maiintindihan natin na kung merong faith dito, kung merong known the Holy Scripture and make thee wise, so ibig sabihin hindi infant yan.
Sunod na nung brother, sa 1 Samuel 2:12 verse 23, sinabi ba dyan ni sabi mo kanina, dinagdagan mo eh, na hindi na babalik sa kay David, ibig sabihin mapunta na ng langit? Meron bang mapunta ng langit dyan na hindi na babalik, brother? Meron nakalagay dyan na mapunta ng langit o dinagdagan mo lang ang 1 Samuel 12:23?
Wala po.
Honestly,
wala pong sinabi na word for word na pupunta sa langit.
Saan that verse?
Sabi ni David, wala po. Sabi ni David, pupunta ako sa kanya, hindi siya babalik sa akin.
So, hindi ibig sabihin na mapunta na ng langit. Wala lang sinabi.
Walang sinabi yan, pero maiintindihan natin kasi si David, kung siya ay mamamatay, saan ba siya pupunta na siya po ay isang alagad ng Diyos, anak ng Diyos, at siya po ang descendant ni Jesus Christ. So maiintindihan natin na andun sa langit yung kanyang anak, kasi doon siya pupunta. Hindi naman siya pupunta sa impyerno.
Next question, Brother Ray. Dito sa 1 Peter chapter 3, mm-hmm, na ginamit ko, at you also make a comment on this earlier, verse 20, letra po letra, mm-hmm, and saved through water and baptism now saves you. Oh, tatanggapin mo ito, Bradley, o hindi? Lahat ng version ng Bible, Catholic and Protestant, baptism saves, letra po letra yan, ha? Ang bautismo, nakakapagligtas. It is a requirement for salvation, letra po letra. Catholic, Protestant, lahat ng Bible. Lahat ba ng Bible, Bradley, tatanggapin mo o you will reject?
Yes, tatanggapin ko nga. Pangalawang sagot ko na yan, ang Biblia, so, tatanggapin saves. Natin. Yes, baptism saves. Amen. Pero anong sabi po ng Biblia? Sabi dito, not the putting away of the filth, but the answer of good conscience. Hindi naman sinabi na baptism can save a person from hell. Pero yung 20, hindi naman yung water, kung iintindihin nyo, save by water, ano po ba, he's talking about the ark of God, of Noah. Ano po ba yung naka-save sa kanila? Yung water o yung ark? So yung ark po yung naka-save, hindi po yung water.
Okay, sunod na tanong. Di ba yung bata na niniwala kay mga Baptist at ibang Protestante has a sinful nature, has original sin, pareha naman tayo Katoliko at Protestante, niniwala kan, di ba? Meron dyan. So ngayon, ang tanong ko sa'yo, based on that doctrine which we both share together, Protestant and Catholics, that we have original sin inherited from Adam and Eve, the sinful nature, does the infants need salvation through baptism? Now, kailangan ba ng infants ng salvation din from sinful nature ng original sin or not? Yes or no? Bradley?
Hindi po kailangan ng infant. Yes, naniniwala tayo na meron sinful nature. So, ang explanation po dyan sa amin o sa Biblia na hindi mo tuturuan ang bata na gumawa ng kasalanan, marunong gumawa ng kasalanan kasi meron siyang infant or mayroon siyang
original sin, sinful nature.
Oo. Pero so, yung Biblia, hindi po naman natin yan i-base lang doon kasi yung given na po yan sa mga tao na may sinful nature, pero yung bata in his innocency, according to the Bible nga, sabi ng Biblia na sa kanila ang karian ng langit. At sa about kay David na yung namatay yung infant niya, so matatanggap po natin, hindi po naman kailangan ng kaligtasan yung infant. Sabi na ng Biblia ni Jesus Christ, I come to seek and to save that which was lost.
Mahaba na ba, Jay? My next question is...
Time naman kasi.
time na ba?
Oo.
Sige.
Tinapos ko na lang yung sagot kasi time.
Sige, pwede kang magbasa dyan ng comments and then we'll proceed to the
summary.
Wala nang comments sa bago. So you can proceed to the summary 5
summary
minutes.
Summary po tayo. Ako po yung mauna at tapos si Bro Alvin.
Okay,
Bro Alvin, simulan ko na po.
Sige, simulan mo na. Set mo ng time.
So, yes. Mga kaibigan, nakita po natin yung mga explanation both sides at again, andito po ako upang manalo sa debating ito. Pwede niyo po akong osgahan, natalo, walang problema. Gusto po na makikita natin yung both sides kung ano po yung tama o ano po yung sabi ng Biblia. So, doon po sa yung mga nabanggit na mga verses, very clear po. So, yung pinakahuli, sabi ng 3:20 ng 1 Peter, saved by water, hindi po naman yan yung water yung nakaligtas kay Noah, kundi yung ark. So, put that in mind. The ark saves their lives, hindi po yung water, okay? Sabi po ng Biblia sa 21, now baptism also saves us. Pero huwag mong putulin po, basahin mo lahat. Sabi ng Biblia, not the putting away the filth of the flesh, but the answer. It will save us for the answer of good conscience toward God. So hindi po naman sinabi yan, it will save a person to go to hell. Ladies and gentlemen, yung kasing baptism about going to heaven or hell, yung water baptism po, hindi po yan, hindi po talaga yan makakaligtas. So according to the Bible, yung Mark 16:16, he that believeth and is baptized, may dalawang baptism po, is it baptism, water, or Holy Spirit baptism. So hindi po yan, hindi po malinaw sa Mark 16:16. Pero ang sabi diyan, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, and he that believeth not. At sabi din ng Biblia, yung being saved is isa po kasi ang issue na natapos na naming talakayin ni Bro Alvin. So hindi na po natin yan dito po tayo mag-focus sa infant baptism. Again po, yung infant baptism para sa akin hindi po naman, we do not forbid you. You can do it if you want to. Pero from the Bible, para sa akin, para sa amin, parang wala lang. Meron pa kayong gastos, okay? So babayaran pa kayong special, regular. Pero wala namang gamit kasi po yung nakasanayan ng mga Pilipino pag magbinyag ng bata, gagastos pa. Yung iba mangungutang pa nga upang may ipapakain, ladies and gentlemen. Pero pwede namang hindi. Pero mga kapatid, ito pong infant baptism, para po sa akin, wala po itong gamit as a child. Again, wala pong ikabahala yung infant pag mamamatay po. Ang sabi ng Biblia, pupunta siya sa langit. They are even nga children, for of such is the kingdom of heaven, sabi ng Biblia. Sa kanila po yung kaharian ng Diyos. At sabi rin ng Biblia, yung Matthew 18, na meron silang mga anghel na nagbabantay sa kanila. So, talaga itong mga bata, ladies and gentlemen, sa Diyos po ito. So, yung mga infant baptism, again, if you want the principles of the Bible, hindi po naman yung command lang yung titingnan mo, babasahin mo, kasi walang forbidden. We are here as a Bible believer. What is said in the Bible, what is commanded, and what is what the apostles are doing, we are doing it. So doon mo yun makikita, ladies and gentlemen, kung sino po yung gumagawa ng mga gawain ng mga apostol. Okay? So kung mga gawain ng mga apostol, hindi po naman sila nagbinyag ng mga bata. If you are going to force that in the text, you can see that. But nevertheless, there are so many instances in the Bible. 13 epistles of Paul, excluding the Hebrews, Peter twice. And then, ladies and gentlemen, meron pang si John, wala po namang, bakit wala pong bata yung mga sabi ng Biblia na infant? Kasi nga, even Jesus Christ was not baptized in his infants. He was baptized 30 years old. So, sino ba ang yung susundin? So, yung bang tao na nagsasabi na mag-baptize kayo ng infant? Or yung Biblia na nag-baptize si Jesus Christ 30 years old. So, ladies and gentlemen, again, you have to read the Bible, the verses that are given here. So, maraming salamat po sa inyong pakikinig. At you can review the video. Tingnan nyo po kung itimbangin nyo po mabuti kung sino po ang tama at alin ang tama sa Biblia, at I hope that you will understand the discussion this evening. So maraming salamat po once again, and also Bro Alvin, salamat po sa iyong oras.
So last summary po, Bro Dre, 5 minutes, diretso na. Okay ng time, sige.
Ikaw.
Maraming salamat, Bro Dre. Now, Bro Dre, it was fellow listeners, Catholics and non-Catholics who are now watching our little dialogue here in Bistec Radio, Winway says that only the ark saved the 8 souls in 1 Peter 3:22-21 and not the water. No! That is a lie, but Ray, because letter by letter, that is 8 souls were saved by water. Saved by water. How can you interpret that? That is very clear and very direct declaration by Peter. We're saved by water in verse 20. The Holy Bible, the way rhymes. How about the King James Protestant, favorite by the Bible Baptist? That is 8 souls were saved by water. Pareha pa rin ang translation eh. Payak na yan, Badre. So, you are lying, Badre, that the ark that saves only. No, the ark saves, I agree. But the water also saves according to Peter. Kaya nga, bakit ang water nakasave? Kasi ito na nga yun, yung figure nga noon, ito na nga yun ang fulfillment. The like figure whereunto, sabi ng King James Version, Even baptism, so the baptism is water, water baptism. The flood is also water. That also now saves us. Oh, napakaliwanag dito sa Dewey's version, sa 21, whereunto baptism, being of the like form, meaning water, water baptism, now saveth you also. Oh, twice, verse 20, water saves you. Ano yung water? Sa verse 21, water baptism saves you. Letra po literal. Kung sabi ni brother, hindi yung tubig nakakaligtas, yun daw arka. Ay kulang brother, hindi lang arka, hindi lang tubig, pati ang pananampalataya ni Noah. Eh hindi ka nalang pala faith alone kasi may arka pa eh. Yung arka, gawa naman yun ni Noah, that is good work. Kung wala pa palang arka, di wal, hindi ka maligtas kung faith alone lang. So that is destructive, brother, to your point. Now I also expose brother na sabi niya kanina, hindi para ang Biblia, ang gospel, ang preaching ng mga apostles to be given to infants kasi hindi pa sila makaintindi. E sinong paninalawalaan natin ngayon na 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 15? And because from the infancy, thou hast known the Holy Scriptures from infancy. Dito, this was infances sa French Bible. And sa Greek, ganun din, blephos. Tapos pinatanong ko sa ka, tatanggapin mo ito, brother? Hindi natatanggapin. Meaning, brother, if you do not accept, this is Protestant interlinear from the Greek by translators Robert T. Brown, Philip Comfort, and J.D. Douglas. Puro itong mga Bible scholars sa Protestant, tapos ayaw mo tanggapin. Meaning, hindi mo talaga tanggap ang salita ng Diyos, mga letra po letra yan. So, brother, you failed in this little dialogue bars. You failed miserably because you have failed to rebut my verses which are very clear. Mark 16:15-16, Matthew 28:18-20, fulfilled by Acts chapter 2, verse 38-39. Letra po letra, the promise is also for infants. Letra po letra in the Greek, technois, little children, sucklings, babes, and infants. So it's not exclusive. Kaya nga walang for prohibition eh. It is not forbidden, Matthew 19:14. Kaya nga ang salvation para din sa mga bata. And that what is fatal birthday to you is that you agreed, like the Catholics, that we inherited original sin from our first parents, Adam and Eve, in paradise. They sinned from the command of God. Now, we are in a state of sinful nature when we are infants from the womb of our mother, Psalms 51:5, Isaiah 48:8, and many more verses in the scriptures, even in the New Testament, Romans 5:12-14-15. So now we're a sinful nature, we're agreed, Baptists, Protestants, and Catholics. Now when we die, where would we go if we're a state of sinful nature and original sin? We will go to hell, not even in limbo. So we need to be baptized so that our original sin will be erased by the giving of the gift of the Holy Spirit, the forgiveness of sins. So they don't need to repent, but they have sins. They have to be given the Holy Spirit to be forgiveness of their sins. Acts 2:38-39. Kaya dun, brother, na time lang, kaya 5 minutes lang, pero dun palang talo ka na kasi sinful nature, okay ka. Tapos mamatay, mapunta ba ng langit ang sinful nature? Hindi. Original sin, they will be punished into hell. Oh, limbo is not even, you cannot see the face of God in limbo. So dun palang, brother, disgrasya na o sira na ang paninindigan ng Baptist Church and Protestant Church which prohibit infant baptism. Kasi infant baptism is a means to save infants who die in original sin and sinful nature. Yun ang purpose. Sabi mo kanina, walang purpose. May purpose kasi may kasalanan. Saan bang kaligtasan natin? Matthew 1:21, Jesus is our Savior because He will save us from our sins. Ang babies pa, may kasalanan, sinful nature, wala. Meron. So, they also need to be saved. Huwag mong sabihin, hindi importante. Hindi na para kaligtasan, wala nang kwenta ang baptism. It is baptism that saves us, including in infants, 1 Peter 3:20-21. So, Verdre, you miserably failed in this very wonderful exchange, although we don't have a moderator, but we respect each other. So, now, it is very clear, ang mas matimbang ang Katoliko kasi lahat letra po letra sa Biblia sa inyo, mga interpretation lang. I'm very sorry, Padre, you again failed for the third time.
Okay, maraming salamat po. That's yan po lahat ng ating talakayan ngayong gabi, yung discussion okay. At debate po.